ना रेडी निंगे रेडिया
After being perpetually in the wait as DMK's crown prince, M.K. Stalin is gearing up to be the next chief minister of Tamil Nadu. This is the first assembly election that the party is fighting without the late M.K. Karunanidhi at the helm. It has been a bittersweet moment for the DMK chief as his elder brother M.K. Alagiri fell out with his father for nominating Stalin as their political heir. The party's strongman, who holds considerable clout in the southern districts of the state and particularly in Madurai, stayed aloof during the whole election process. But one factor that worked in Stalin's favour was the anti-incumbency generated by 10-year-long uninterrupted rule by AIADMK and the absence of charismatic mass leader J. Jayalalitha to stave it off. As a force multiplier, the DMK chief roped in Prashant Kishore to manage his campaigning. So let's take a look at Stalin and what he means for DMK and Tamil Nadu. M.K. Stalin, born in 1953, is the third son of Karunanidhi and Kalangar, named him as a tribute to the powerful communist leader of Soviet Union, Joseph Stalin. And from the early days, it was clear Stalin would bear the mantle of Karunanidhi's political legacy. In fact, in his interview with Network 18, Stalin explained how his father had groomed him for a career in politics.
அவரோட இருந்து நான் கட்சியில் பிறந்தவன், அதனால் வந்து புதுசாக கற்றுக்கணும் அவசியம் இல்லை. அப்புறம் வந்து 13-14 வயசுலேருந்து நான் வந்து ஸ்கூலில் படிக்கிறதுலேருந்து படிப்படியாக கற்றுக்கிட்டு அவருடைய பயிற்சியில் வளர்ந்ததுனால அது எனக்கு அது உதவியாக இருக்குது. அவர் வந்து கூட்டணி கட்சியோட பேசுனது, தேர்தலில் சந்திக்கிறது, பிரச்சாரத்தினோட வியூகம், எப்படி கூட்டணி கட்சி அரவணைச்சு அழைச்சிட்டு போகிறது, பொதுமக்கள்கிட்ட எப்படி பிரச்சாரம் பண்ணுறது, எப்படி அப்படிங்கிறதெல்லாம் எல்லாம் உண்மை தான் அவர்கிட்ட கற்றுக்கிட்டது.
Stalin was associated in the party's campaign since the days when Annadurai was leading the party. He was arrested during emergency and apparently had to undergo torture in custody. He became an MLA in 1989 from Thousand Lights constituency in Chennai. His first major administrative assignment was as a mayor of Chennai, where he was directly elected in 1996. During Karunanidhi's final term as the chief minister, Stalin became the deputy chief minister in 2009. In 2013, 2 years after DMK lost power to AIADMK, Karunanidhi named Stalin as his political heir. Post Kalangar's demise in 2019 polls, Stalin led the DMK Congress Left Alliance to a stellar performance, winning 38 out of 39 parliamentary seats. Stalin is not an iconoclast when it comes to his religious beliefs. He is not a feisty person like Periyar, the father of the Dravidian movement, who would make it a point by hitting out at Hindu gods and goddesses. And unlike his father, Karunanidhi, who publicly called himself atheist, in spite of admitting that he does not love God either, he has gone on record saying that his wife goes to temples and he has no problems with DMK party members publicly practicing their faith. This is a big departure from DMK's past practices when visiting temples was looked down upon by party apparatchiks. Stalin is also a staunch supporter of federalism and has been vocal against BJP's alleged malpractices of engineering downfall of elected government and hoisting their own as happened in Madhya Pradesh. He views the new education policy as another example of Hindi and Sanskrit imposition and has promised not to implement it if voted to power. The other area where Stalin has focused his energy is presenting a clean image of the party, a far cry from UPA 2 days when the party was blamed for corruption in spectrum allocation for 2G. He didn't mince words before branding AIADMK as a party meant for collecting commission.
ஆண்டு கொண்டிருக்கக்கூடிய அதிமுக ஆட்சி, அது வந்து 10 வருஷமா அவர் பாழுக்கு கணத்தில் போயிட்டு இருக்கு. இப்போ இந்த ஆட்சி வந்து கரப்ஷன், கமிஷன், கலெக்ஷன் தான் ஒரு குறிக்கோளை வச்சுட்டு இந்த ஆட்சி நடந்துக்கிட்டு இருக்கு. ஜெயலலிதாவுடைய மறைவுக்கு பிறகு இந்த ஆட்சி காப்பாற்றிக்கணுங்கிறதுல தான் அக்கறை எடுத்து செயல்பட்டுருக்காங்க. தவிர 4 வருஷமா திட்டங்கள் செய்யணும், மக்கள் செய்யலை.
Today's Tamil politics is as much about holding the Tamil pride Dravidian culture as it is about doling out freebies. And Stalin is a past master in it, as the DMK manifesto has made a plethora of promises, 500 to be precise. From decreasing prices of petrol to paying 100 rupees to LPG consumers to starting a prototype of universal basic income, Stalin's DMK has metaphorically promised the moon. The chief minister-designate even had a fallout with Kamal Haasan during the campaign when the matinee idol accused him of appropriating their agenda. For now, it seems Karunanidhi was sagacious enough to bestow his political legacy to his third son, who could keep the DMK flag fluttering higher. The question is, will he deliver and bring in a new era for the party?